And we're back. Welcome to Off the Shelf Reviews, where we provide real-world reviews of primarily 1/6 scale collectible figures. We give you the most realistic in-hand look at these pieces so that you know what to expect if you decide to acquire them for your collection. That means no light boxes, no studios, and as usual, I maintain a focal length and depth of field that best mimic the human eyesight. So what are we looking at today? The Sideshow Collectibles exclusive 1/6 scale Jack Burton from Big Trouble in Little China. As usual, we'll discuss why this piece belongs in any collection, we'll talk about some likes and dislikes, and then we'll rate the piece as a top shelf, middle shelf, or bottom shelf collectible. So let's get started. So here he is out of the box. The box, incidentally, is shoebox style and very well done with artwork in the style of the film. The figure comes in a standard clamshell plastic with several trays for accessories. Now, in a world of 1/6 scale Iron Men and Mandalorians, you may be asking, what is Big Trouble in Little China? Or who is Jack Burton?
Who? Jack Burton. Me.
Quick history lesson. In the summer of 1986, 20th Century Fox released the martial arts action comedy Big Trouble in Little China, directed by John Carpenter and starring Kurt Russell in the lead role of Jack Burton. The film tells the story of how Jack Burton helps his friend Wang Chi rescue Wang's fiancée from the mystical and magical ancient Chinese underworld hidden under San Francisco Chinatown. This film was very unique. Back in 1986, the ninja fad was ending, and other than Bruce Lee's Enter the Dragon in 1973, there really hadn't been any Hollywood films with Asian-style martial arts action. Even Chuck Norris's films were much more American-style action with some karate flavor. So in the modern era, this was the first Hollywood film to not only feature Asian-style martial arts, but also one of the only Hollywood films where almost the entire cast and the majority of the leads were also Asian actors. But the film was a box office disaster. So why own this collectible?
Why?
Since its release and over the years on home video, Big Trouble in Little China has become a cult classic and is regularly found on best movies of all time lists. To be fair, the Chinese history and culture shown in the movie is mostly made up, similar to the Indian culture shown in Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom.
Oh. Sneak! Surprise!
What's the surprise?
But that said, the Chinese cast and crew to this day are very proud of the film and happy with the experience in making it. And as a mixed race, part Chinese person myself, I don't feel that it portrays Chinese people in a negative light. But looking past that, I think it's one of Kurt Russell's best performances as he imbues Jack with layers of depth, showing bravery, insecurity, uncertainty, and fear, all under a mask of bravado. One of the great characters in modern film, Jack Burton.
Jack Burton!
Yeah! Go ahead.
Boy, the guy you always told me about, huh?
Give me that.
This figure was announced for the 30-year anniversary of the film and was released in spring of 2018. It's part of Sideshow's Cult Classics lineup, and it's limited to only 1,500 pieces worldwide. So what do we like about this figure? Well, let's start with the head sculpt. This figure is a perfect example of why it's so important to have a proper camera and natural lighting to show what the figure actually looks like. This head sculpt is actually one of Sideshow's better efforts. When you look at the detail in the hair, it's very nicely done. The skin tone isn't quite up to, say, Hot Toys standards from as far as realism goes, but it's a very nice effort for Sideshow. The eyes are certainly nicely painted and alive. There's a hint of 5 o'clock shadow, and there's even some pretty good detail in the mouth. The expression, I mean, there's some folks that would have preferred a more neutral expression, but I actually really like this because this sort of puzzled, what's going on look is actually the most common expression that he has on his face during the film. As far as the outfit goes, Jack comes dressed in his trademark Fu Manchu tank top, which is really well done. It's an excellent representation of the print. He's also wearing blue jeans, nice high-waisted fit appropriate to the mid-80s time period. He also has his trademark boots, which are really well sculpted. A lot of detail there. The boots are one piece, but they are soft enough that they allow some ankle articulation. He also has a wristwatch, which again, nicely sculpted, accurate to the film, and it hides the wrist joint. And then lastly, he also comes with this jean jacket.
Here it is on the figure.
The body is a standard Sideshow body with over 20 points of articulation. I can't remember if it's 23 or 26. It's pretty standard. As usual, I won't be demonstrating the articulation as this is my own figure, and I'm not looking to stress test it. The body is a little more lean and fit than Kurt Russell was at the time, but it is an action figure, so to be honest, I'm fine with that. Height-wise, scales very nicely with other 1/6 scale figures. Alright, so let's talk about accessories. As mentioned, he comes with this great 1980s style denim jacket. Very well done, looks excellent. He comes with his Tech 9 semi-automatic machine pistol that he uses in the film. He also comes with his boot knife. Unfortunately, the boot knife doesn't actually fit in the boot, but the sculpt is well done. It does look just like the knife in the film. He comes with an assortment of hands to carry all of his weapons. And then lastly, he comes with the best accessory of all, the Guardian.
My God, no. Please, what is that? Don't tell me.
The Guardian is basically a floating eyeball monster, and it's very, very well done. Excellent paint work all over the piece. Great work on every one of these multiple eyes. I'm pretty sure it has almost all the eyes that is seen in the film. I think there was one missing somewhere on the back that I noticed, but for the most part, just an awesome, awesome job. When you look at the texture, like I said, the paint work, it really is a creepy looking thing. He's not quite as moist or slick as I would have liked, but really nicely done. So what are my dislikes? Although the head sculpt is pretty good, it really doesn't have that realistic miniature human paintwork seen on other high-end figures. The figure would also do well to have double-jointed elbows. These are single-jointed elbows, and although he doesn't really need that much flexibility in his lower half, certainly double-jointed elbows would have given you a little more flexibility in the posing. Although the jean jacket itself is really well done, I would much rather if they included the sweatshirt he's shown wearing earlier in the film. And that being said, it would have been great if they included a secondary head sculpt, perhaps with a baseball hat that he wears when he's wearing the sweatshirt, or with a different expression and lipstick as he's shown later on in the film, which I won't spoil for you. All right, time to rate this figure, but before we do, let's take a look at the shelf pose. Oh yeah. As you can see here, I just wanted to take advantage of the expression on the face. So I left him without the jean jacket in an iconic Jack Burton look where he's basically ready for action, but at the same time, totally out of his depth. So back to the rating. My collection is based on nostalgia and my childhood during the late 70s and early 80s. And at that time, my brother and I were huge fans of those classic Shaw Brothers and Golden Harvest Kung Fu films. So to see that type of action on screen was incredibly refreshing. The cut and sew, the clothing's excellent and very accurate to the film. And the inclusion of the Guardian was a really nice touch. But it's not perfect. The paint on the head sculpt could have been better. And perhaps this figure could have included other accessories, other clothing, or additional head sculpts. So taking all that into account, I would rate this figure as a middle shelf collectible. Let me know if you agree in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Subscribe if you want, and stick around till the end of the video for a quick preview of the next review. But for now, it's time to get this collectible back on the shelf.
Meanwhile, at the Hall of Justice.
Oh, yeah.